Hello and welcome to module number one of Breaking Through Your Sugar Cravings. So I just want to say thank you so much for giving me this opportunity to help you and just entrusting me to work with you guys on sugar cravings. I know what it's like to have sugar and just these sweet cravings to really rule your life, even if it's something that you think that is healthy, because I've totally been there and telling myself that, you know, a little bit is okay, but really I just wanted to get this program out and share what helped me in my journey in helping to really balance my blood sugar levels, because that affects everything else in your life. It affects your metabolism. It affects how your body stores fat and our hormones, and they all play a role in how we feel. So I just wanted to kind of go over what the first module will be about. So I'm going to talk about food and how it affects our body. I'll talk about healthy sources of fat, fats to avoid, carbohydrates that are healthy, carbohydrates that you're going to want to avoid. I'll also give you like tips and advice on how to start your day. These are all going to be in a PDF format for you. And if you ever have any questions, please just feel free to reach back out to me. I want to start a little Facebook group so that we can encourage each other, and it'd be a good place for us to be able to answer any questions as well. And I also have a list of supplements that have really helped me in my journey and helped bringing my body back into balance. And these supplements are really powerful because they are nourishing my body. And a lot of times when your body has cravings, it's actually trying to tell you something. It's not necessarily a bad thing. You know, our bodies crave things because it's missing out on certain nutrients and minerals, and so this has really helped me figure out how to fill in those gaps so that all of a sudden my body's not craving certain things. Like, I used to have a need, like a strong need, to have dark chocolate or any kind of chocolate every single day. I could not live without it, and I would say I would just, you know, like a little square, and I would end up eating the whole bar of chocolate. Like, I couldn't stop myself. And so just reading and studying nutrition for, you know, a little over a decade, I've realized what my cravings mean. And so, yeah, I just want to be able to help you guys as well. So we're going to help reset your body, reset your metabolism, because whenever we have insulin resistance, our metabolisms are messed up. So we have to reteach our body how to use glucose. And every time we are eating a meal, eating a snack, our insulin is spiking. And so when it's spiking, all we're doing is just storing that as fat instead of burning it. So we need to like reteach your body. So I will have a full menu, 7 days, breakfast, lunch, and dinners of food to help you nourish your body. And it's important to eat enough food so that you can get to the next meal without having those hypoglycemic episodes. And it may take you time, you may need to have snacks. So I am going to have a list of snacks that you can eat as well. So don't be afraid to eat those snacks if you need them, but we need to make sure that they're going to be nourishing snacks, and snacks that will satiate you instead of spiking your insulin and blood sugar levels even more. So as your body learns to maintain your blood sugar levels, you're actually going to be eating less. So you won't be snacking as much over time. That is the goal. So you want to get 3 to 4 hours in between your meals so that you're not thinking about food. And that may seem far-fetched now and crazy, but you will get there, and it'll take baby steps. I'll also include some desserts for you, because this isn't about not ever enjoying a sweet treat or something. It's just how we, when we introduce it into our day, and the kind of sugar you know, sweetener that we're allowing into our diet as well. So anyways, enjoy module number one. I'll get started on module number two for you guys. Take your time with it. Remember, baby steps. If you make a mistake or fail, you know, the next meal is always an opportunity. So don't beat yourself up, because I've totally done that too. So anyways, thank you and God bless.